articles, and periodicals. There are a few print newspapers, magazines, and scholarly journals in the SCC library, but most of the thousands of periodicals in our library collection reside in library databases. Using databases, you can search for articles on a topic of your choice, then you can narrow your search to only articles from newspapers, like the Spokesman Review or the New York Times, or narrow your search to magazines like Newsweek or Time, or view articles in any of the scholarly and professional journals which are in our databases. Here's a demonstration. To find periodical articles and other electronic information sources, we'll use library databases. We'll start at the library homepage. Choose Start Your Research, and then scroll down. Notice at the very bottom of the page, there's the chat box for 24/7 live chat with a librarian. But we want to find articles, so we're going to select Research Databases. The library has about 80 databases. It can be hard to decide which to choose, so it's fine to ask a librarian. Notice that there are ebook databases, image databases, streaming audio and video, and article databases. We're looking for articles, so I'll choose those. One of our most frequently used databases is ProQuest, and it says here it's a database of articles from magazines, newspapers, trade publications, and scholarly journals. The information in our library databases is not freely available online. That's why we subscribe to these databases for students to use. You'll have to authenticate that you're a currently enrolled student by entering your Bigfoot login. My login looks different than yours. If you have any problems logging in, contact a librarian right away. Or call the IT Help Desk at 533-HELP. Now I'm going to look for articles that are about college students and ADHD. Notice that if your search terms are a phrase, you can enter them in quotation marks. In this case, ProQuest will search through all the articles in this database that have the phrase college students, those two words, in that order, and it'll also find articles that have the term ADHD. I could narrow my results to peer-reviewed articles, and I could change the date range that I'm searching, but I'll just do a simple search. ProQuest has retrieved about 3,000 results. All these articles have the phrase college students and the term ADHD in the title or description or the full text of the article. Here's where I might want to limit my date range. If I didn't want to look at articles from the 1980s, for example, and only wanted articles from the past 5 years, I could update my results using this date slider. I can also choose what type of periodical I want articles from. If your assignment requires that you use scholarly journal articles, go ahead and choose those. There are also newspaper, magazine, and other types of articles. I'll choose scholarly journal articles. Now it's just a matter of me browsing through the articles. I can preview them and read an abstract or summary of the article and select one that I'm interested in. For example, this article, Interventions for ADHD in Children and Teens, a focus on ADHD coaching in a journal called Pediatric Nursing, sounds of interest to me. Click on the title. You'll find an abstract, which is a summary of the article, and then the full text of the article follows. If there's a PDF version of the full text available, it's a good idea to choose that. It's easier to read. Here's the full article. All library databases have tools you can use to do things with the article. So you can email it, save it, print it, and then click the Cite button to generate a pre-formatted citation in a style of your choosing. Copy and paste this citation and put it in your bibliography. So you can see that using library databases will make your research quicker. You can efficiently search for articles on a specific topic in a specific type of periodical, in this case a scholarly journal, and you can generate a pre-formatted citation. If you have questions about using library databases or searching them, just ask a librarian.